Hello friends, welcome to PLC Tech. Today I will tell you how to do the wiring of servo drive. I have a servo drive ASDA-B2 and I will tell you the connection and its parameter and how you can connect the pin number to operate the servo drive. I will tell you the pin number also, which pin number you will have to connect with plus and which pin number you will have to connect with negative. For connecting it servo motor and PLC also. So at first I am telling you the basic connection of servo drive. Here I have power input and that is contactor, that is MCB, that is EMI filter. I have power from my input and these connections are given to L1, L2. Here are RST for servo drive, that is connector 1 through which we connect the IO to the servo motor or external. That is my connector 2 of encoder. We connect it with servo encoder and that is my USB cable to connect with the PC. That is my regenerative resistor. These are the details of connectors. Here L1C, L2C, these are control circuit terminal and RSTR main circuit terminal and UVWR servo motor output. UVW we connect with the servo. Here UVW you will have to connect 3 wire, red, white and black with the servo, but you will get sometime red, yellow and blue wire of the servo cable. Then you will have to connect at white you will connect yellow and at black you will connect black, and that is for earthing. You will connect it with the earthing through which we used input and output, and connector 2 is for encoder, that is used for connecting the encoder, and connector 3 is used for communication, that is used for communication by the PC. That is a method of wiring of servo. You can operate the servo drive with this single phase power supply and 3 phase power supply, but with single phase power supply you can operate up to 1.5 kilowatt and below of it you can operate. If you have higher than 1.5 kilowatt, then you will have to give it only 3 phase power supply. For connection, you can see here that power on contact A normally open and power off you will have to connect NC. NC and NO button you will have to connect for on and off the drive. Here you can see the wiring of that is my servo drive and that is its connection input RST and that is L1 L2. In some drive you will get L1 L2 at above the RST. For connecting it you will have to make the looping of R and S with L1 L2 for connecting the single phase input, and UVW you will have to connect the motor with it. And that pin 21 and 27 my output for the real alarm. If there is any alarm it will show. Here I will tell you that here that I have made, we have made that control wiring, that is for making on the servo drive. Here I will tell you that there are 6 output digital output and 9 are digital inputs that are positive and negative. You can choose according to you. And 4 parameters for that are parameter P22, P210 and P217, 10 to 17 and P236. And other parameters P2 is main and 18 to 22 and 37. These are for input and outputs. You can maintain according to you. And for encoder, A plus, A phase, and single phase and double phase, you can both use for the pulse. That is connector. That is my 44 pin connector used in detail. Pin number, that is pin number, and that is digital output. It's showing that it is our digital output. Here we use only some pins for connecting the using the server drive to connect with the PLC or HMI. You can use on, we have to use only 8 to 10 pin to operate a server drive. Here you can see that there is DI1 and this is showing negative. Then it means you will have to connect with it at 9 pin negative point. You will have to connect only when it is showing DO1 positive, then you will have to connect 24 to this pin number. And these are pulse 35 36 37 38 39 40 41. These are used for pulse input and high speed pulse out input. I will tell you in detail here. For operating a machine in position mode, a servo drive, you will have to use only 43 41 39 37 and 35 pin. At 35 pin you will have to give the opposite of the pin number. You will connect one pulse and one sign. You will have to give its opposite, and its parameter is P100 for clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. Now here is a pin VDD 17, that is for source voltage, that is positive, and COM 11 and COM negative is 14. Then you will have to continue make the on. You will have to connect with 11, and to give the negative you will connect it with point with pin 14. Here I will show you. If you want to make the on the servo ready, then you will have to connect the pin number 7, or you can use 6. If you are using 6, then you will have to give it negative, and you are using 7, then you will have to connect positive. You want to make servo on, then you will have to reset the its alarm also. When you will make the servo on, pin 9 you will have to connect with positive or negative. You can see that connector. In connector you can find alarm reset at 33 pin. For resetting the fault, you will have to use the 33 pin with NMOS switch. When you will press it, it will reset all the alarms. For clearing the all the activated pulse, you will have to connect 10, pin number 10, and emergency. That is for emergency. If your machine, when you will connect the power, you will make it on your, if you have not connected pin number 13 with the negative, your machine will show emergency alarm. When you will connect it with 30 number pin, then it will show other alarm, maybe or not. If your machine is showing alarm number 14 and 15, then you will have to connect the pin 31 to 32 with as a NC with the 0 volt. Now your machine will be ready to use. You can use it. Here I will show you the position mode, position control mode, how to be we will connect the drive in position control mode. In position control mode, I want to tell you that you will use only pin number 37, pin number 41 and pin number 35. Here you are not getting, you cannot see here because that is not maintained here. You will have to connect pin number 37 and 41 with direction for direction and pulse, and at 35 you will have to give the opposite sign of 37 or 41. If you will connect the same sign with the at the pin number 35, then your servo drive will show the alarm. And here you can see that at COM positive it is given by pin number 17, but I will use the out source. Then I will connect it 11 and 9 pin 9, continue with the out source with positive. Then my servo will go on, and for making its emergency alarm reset, I will connect pin number 30 with negative sign, and pin number 33 I will connect it also as a NO with NO switch with negative sign for resetting the alarm. For forward and reverse, I will have to connect with NC switch 32 and 31 with negative sign, 0 volt. I will have to connect in NC 32 and 31. And for servo ready, I will have to connect the in NC with 7 also, to pin number 7 and pin number 11 and pin number 35. I will have to give positive 24 volt, you can say. All other pins you will have to give negative means 0 volt. When your now connecting these, your servo drive will be ready to use. Now after connecting all the pins, when you will make power on, here at the display there will be no alarm. If there is any alarm, you can go in manual, and at chapter 9 you will get the troubleshooting and finding the solution. You can solve your problem. Okay friends, that was my today's chapter for wiring of servo drive. That is very easy to operate your servo drive with servo, and to use it in position mode and torque mode and position and torque mode and speed mode according to you. You will have to change its parameter and you can use it. In my further chapter, I will tell you how to use the servo drive in jog mode. Please like and subscribe my channel PLC Tech. Thanks.